Be it pest control, keeps wasps away, wasp repelling decoy nest. All right then. The eco-friendly, see, as soon as anything starts off with a sentence eco-friendly, already I'm thinking, you've only put that on there to see if any sucker will buy it. No mess solution to ensuring your home or garden is a wasp-free zone. Well, how's that eco-friendly? Plus also plastic. Works by imitating an enemy wasp nest, making territorial wasps steer clear of to avoid attack. Really? Really? Apparently wasps not included. I don't know why. Like, that's not, that doesn't look like a wasp, that looks more like an ant. And that doesn't look like a wasp either, it's weird. And they've put it plenty of times. Silly. Yeah, and it says the same on the back. So they put it in a plastic bag. Actually, it just looks like a paper lampshade. Put a light bulb in that, and it looks like it's a paper lampshade stained with tea. It also looks like a Chinese lantern, you know, you put the candle underneath it and it floats away. How was that supposed to look like a wasp's nest? They've also gone to the expense of putting a metal aisle in to hang it up in the shop, which is also a waste. And let's get this silliness open. What do we get inside? Wasps not included. And there it is. It's a piece of paper, a load of bits of wire in it. It's a paper lampshade. That's what it is. It's like an accordion. It's like completely stereo, loving that. It's like bellows. And I suppose you put this metal thing inside it to keep it up. Okay then, let's do that then. So you do that. Because there's no instructions, I'm just guessing at this point. And you bring it up. You see, I'm just expecting a wasp to move into this. I'm just expecting a wasp to go, hang on a minute, got a ready-made house here. This is actually quite difficult to do without bending the wire. Actually, can you see the wire bending? The wire is bending under the weight of its own spring action. This looks absolutely ridiculous. It looks awful. You're gonna have that. What's that noise? It's like some sort of instrument. And next on Britain's Got Talent, we've got Charles Fleming, and he's going to be playing the imitation wasp's nest. This is so stupid. You're gonna get birds nesting in it. That looks stupid. You're gonna have this piece of tat for £1.49 hanging around in your garden. Maybe you could use it as some sort of listening post. I hear the bees. I hear the bees. Why do I keep saying bees? It's like for wasps, isn't it? Yeah, then let's put it in this tree and let's prevent wasps by making it look as if we've already got them in the garden. Oh, this is pretty stupid. Stupid. Oh, there's a fly. Flies are not scared of the wasp's nest. There's a busy bee. There's several busy bees in this little flowery thing. Not fazed at all by this thing. What a piece of tat. Look, there's loads of little things flying around. Look. Nothing's bothered by this. What a piece of tat. So I'm going to remove that. And I found these! Solar-powered ladybird. Lights. How cute! So I'm going to stick them on the tree instead. It's grass bell me. Bye! This stupid thing. If anything, wasps are going to make bloody more wasp nest out of it. Stupid. And I think I'll put one on there. Ah, put on top of the Christmas tree. There we are. Fabulous. Found that the Christmas tree's got lights. Yay, the work! There's one on top of the Christmas tree. It's too dark to see the tree, probably. Ah, there we go. And one in a sycamore tree. Oops, it turned off because the light of the camera was on it. Light goes on, light goes off, light goes on, light goes off, light goes on, light goes off.